Hi, my name is Khan and welcome to the new chapter. In this chapter, we are going to learn that how we can identify smart money trap and what is SMT. SMT means smart money trap, and this type of liquidity based on the smart money traders who trade based on the boss, chalk and order block. But every order block, every break of structure is not SMC. SMC means to identification liquidity. Once you identify liquidity, then you can identify where is our high probability POI for the buy and sell. Majority of the smart money traders fail because they don't know exactly where is our real boss, where is our real order block, where is our POI. So everything will be continue here, and I will show you exactly that how we can identify them and how we can differentiate and how we can create a difference from the other smart money traders. Do you know smart money traders majority of the time fail compared to the retail traders? Because smart money traders trade based on the very small stop loss, like 2 pips, 5 pips, and they are looking for buy or sell indirectly. Sometime they directly buy or sell based on the order block, based on the break of structure. But as a retail traders, they always buy or sell most of the time. But majority of the retail traders, they buy or sell based on their system, like trend line broken, pattern broken and indicator indication, and they put stop loss based on the structure maximum time. But smart money traders problem is here, they putting the stop loss just below above the order block. Smart money traders most of the time, smart money traders always try to reduce risk, not in terms of the capital. They reduce risk in terms of the pip, like 5 pip stop loss, 2 pip stop loss, and below the 2 pip stop loss. 2 pip stop loss, 5 pip, 3 pip is not SMC. Smart money means finding a way to identification liquidity, find the liquidity and trade as per your trading plan. It doesn't mean that you are putting a stop loss 1 pip and 2 pips. This can be your 15 pip stop loss, this can be a 50 pip stop loss, and also can be 2 pip stop loss. But it's depend. Stop loss can't be decided that you are a SMC trader or a retail trader. It's all about psychology, it's all about perspective, that how you are looking to market and how you are reacting on the chart and how you are looking for the buy or sell. Now I'm going to show you exactly that how we can identify break of structure, false break of structure, false change of character and false OB, which act like a SMT smart money trap. So this is our bearish trend, correct? And this one is not about time frame, and this can be applied in a lower time frame, in a higher time frame. So don't think about that this is a 1 minute chart, and this can be your higher time frame, 15 minute, 1 hour. This is just example to understand that how we can identify where is our valid order block and where is our valid break of structure. So generally in a smart money concept, lot of people are marking a wrong structure. So start from the top of the structure. If you can see here, in this case, what is this? Market momentum is completely bearish. So how people are looking for the buy or sell, and how most of the smart money traders, they mark the structure like this one. Market momentum is completely bearish. So what happened here? Market take a pullback and break the previous high. What is this? This one, correct? If this previous high broken and they called it a chalk, some people call it chalk and some people call it a boss. And then what happened here? After this break of structure, after this change of character, people are looking for the buy on the order block. Where is our order block? This one. So when market momentum is a bearish and convert into bullish structure, and now people are looking for the buy because they anticipating price turning into bearish to bullish. So this one is our demand zone is here, and lot of people are introduced here for buy. That's why market gave small reaction to the upside, and then what happened? Market failed. Why this move happened here? Because they induced two smart money traders to buy here. Once market failed this order block, and then what happened? Once market failed this order block, then what happened here? Market again turned into continuation, which is a bearish trend is here. So what is this? This one is also called our break of structure, because this was our first indication for the reversal. This one is our first indication for the reversal, and you can mark as a change of character is here, right? And then what happened here? After this break of structure, what people are looking for sell or buy is here. Which one is here? Correct. Why people are looking here for sell? Because break the structure, and this one is our order block. But in reality, this one is a valid order block or not? This is one just assumed. Why? Because after break the structure, there is no inducement to confirm any lower low, to take an entry, you need to wait for taking out the inducement, then you can identify. If you are selling without inducement, without liquidity sweep, it means you are exempt. So same thing happen here. After this one, people are looking for sell, and most of the time what happened, price not mitigate your order block, and then market push downside continue in an impulsive wave, and they again what happened here, the mark, this one is our again break of structure, and this one is our break of structure. Again people are looking for sell at this point. Which one is here, which one is the candle here? Some people mark this one because this is our last buying candle before the stop, and they don't care about imbalance, they don't care about candlestick, but market not tap here. And then what happened here, this one is a new break of structure or not? But technically this is not a break of structure, but some people mark this one is also a supply zone. Which one is here? They also anticipating that price must be tap here. And then what happened here, market give small reaction at this point, and then market go higher, collect all money, and then finally market push downside. So this one is also SMT at this point. Okay, so these move happen most of the time with smart mini traders, but in reality as we know that this one is our only single leg and this one is our only one pullback is here. So how we mark this one is our as a pullback. So this one is our lowest low, which one is here, and this one is our lower high. Once market broke this one, this one is our valid break of structure, right? So this one is a not a chalk, this one is just inducement at this point. Again market push downside and there is no entry. These are all SMT until taken out the inducement. So in this case, where is our inducement in this case? This one is our first pullback is here. This one is our first pullback is here, which is must be taken out because this one is our first pullback as we have discussed in a marking structure map. As we have discussed in a structure mapping, market must be taken out the first pullback. First pullback was here at this point, but market not taken out this high, and market create new pullback at this point. So finally market taken out this high. After taking out this high, you can simply sell here at this point. So this one is a not SMT. So after taking out the first inducement, simply you can sell here at this point, and this is our valid entry criteria for the sell at this point. And then what happened here after this move, right? Market create new structure like this. This is our lower low and this become our lower high. And do not try to buy here on this order block because people are looking for the buy or sell based on this only order block. When they see any order block, they create randomly structure, they create randomly setup for the buy or sell. Order block is not SMC. Order block we just use to refine your entry criteria for the buy or sell. Order block is not SMC. And after this move, what happened here? Market create new break of structure is here, and this one is our valid break of structure technically based on this one because market taken out the inducement, and after taking out the inducement what happened here, market broke this low and create new structure. Which one is here? Once market close below it, again what happened here, at this point what happened here after this break of structure? After the break of structure, people are looking for sell here and here, right? But these are not a valid sell. These are all SMT until creating the new inducement at this point, right? So if you are buying or selling without inducement, it means you are selling on SMT point. So you have to wait for to create a new just you have to wait for to create new inducement before the buy or sell. And this one is a not a break of structure as we know because market not taken out any inducement. Simply break the structure is here. Where is our SMT? This one. Right, and this SMT is not a valid here because SMT is always below the inducement always, right? And why not this one is a valid SMT? Because this become our valid setup for the sell. First high, or you can say first order block, is always SMT after break the structure. And this one is also not a break of structure. Technically this one is our valid break of structure is here. And do not try to sell here because people are looking for sell after break the structure randomly on order block. Price tap here, small giving market trying to push downside, giving small reaction. People are introduced here for the sell, right? But you have to wait for taking out this inducement. Once market taken out this inducement, you can simply sell here. Okay, so when we can sell here, we can sell on this order block, which one is here. And now this one is our perfect, and this one is our valid entry for the sell, and this one is, and this low become our lower low at this point, right? So now we have a structure something like this. Okay, so this one is our actual structure is here. Okay, so this is our real structure, and you can see there are different now you can see there are big difference in a normal structure in true SMC structure. And how you can see, and simply you can see there are, and same process happen here. This is our SMT because there is a no inducement just below it, so we can't sell here. Okay, so we can always sell after taking out the inducement. Taking out the inducement, tap on this order block, sell here. Again break the structure. Okay, and some people, and this is inducement, but some people mark this as a change of character. Why? Because they are anticipating price was bearish, and now price trying to push higher to create a structure something like this. Let me show you exactly like this. Okay, break this high. Okay, sometime close and sometime not close. In this case, price close of it. So generally people are looking for the buy at this point. Which one? On this order block, because this one is our clean order block. That's why market keeping a momentum to the upside before the stop, right? So this one is why this move happened here, because people are looking here for buy, and they again mark this as a chalk here, because people, and they called this demand is a failed and now turn into bearish and turn into supply, right? So these things happen, and these things will be continue in smart money concept. So you have to remember when you are looking for the buy, when you are looking for sell, always remember this is a valid structure or not. If you are marking any order block, remember one thing: are you selling below the inducement or are you selling above the inducement? If you are selling in a bearish market above the inducement, it means you are selling on high probability POI for the sell. When you sell or buy below the inducement, just below the inducement or inducement point, it means you are SMT, smart money trap. Now you can see there are a lot of SMT. Why? Because people are buying here. Maybe you are not buying, or maybe you are buying here, but lot of people are introduced here for buy or sell. SMC is also retail theory. That's why you have to focus on liquidity, because main thing is the liquidity in smart money concept, in a retail concept, based on the session timing, based on the daily candle high or low sweep, or based on the structure high or low. You don't need to understand that where is our order block, where is our anything. Simply you can take trade if you find the liquidity. Liquidity is a big game in a smart money concept. I'm not saying trade on order block, trade on structure. You can simply buy or sell. You can simply take trade based on the session high or low. Every session high or low act like a liquidity. You can also buy or sell just below or above in the major structure high or low, because every major structure high or low act like a liquidity. Identify liquidity and trade it. Simple. Main thing to identification: liquidity. Find the liquidity, then you will get high probability setup for the buy and sell. And after this break of structure, what happened here? At this point, as you can see here, market break this low, and a lot of people are looking here for sell, because this is our last selling move before this. This is last buying move for this step, and a lot of people are introduced here for sell. Once you are selling here, then where is your stop loss? Maximum time your stop loss just above the order block. Right, so what happened here after this one? You can see here, this stop loss taken out by this shadow. Why this move happened here? This is not randomly. Market can't go higher and lower without any reason. Simple. So you have to focus on single candlestick move and measure structure high, low, and order block everywhere. You have to notice everywhere, because every moment is a unique. This move happened because everyone selling here. Why? Because most of the traders are looking for sell here after this break of structure, because this one is our order block. Some people mark this as our order block because the last buying momentum before the stop is here. People are looking for sell, give a small reaction here, and after this, what happened here? Lot of smart money traders introduced here for sell. They are anticipating now price turning into bearish side. Market collect all money is here and then push downside. So these things will be continue in smart money concept, in a retailer's concept. In smart money concept, is not means that you are making money or you can also make money. It's all about probability. You have to remember this thing. First of all, that's why you have to focus on majority of the time on a liquidity. Liquidity is a king, you can say. Simple. If you are asking me what is the backbone of smart money concept, which is a liquidity. Simple. That's why I'm focusing on liquidity for you. So I hope you understand that what is the SMT and how we can identify them, where you should trade or not. And these things will be continue in a bullish market, in a bearish market, everywhere. You will see every market is a bullish or bearish, doesn't matter. Liquidity is everywhere, SMT is everywhere, and retail liquidity is also everywhere. You have to identify them, first identify them and then trade it. Do not buy or sell randomly on order block like this. This one is an order block and you are marking this as a chalk, and this is a boss chalk and order block. No, you don't need to buy or sell only. You don't need to buy or sell randomly on based on the order block only. You must have a specific reason for the buy or sell. Don't trade randomly with your order block. Order block is not SMC. I'm repeating again and again. That's why. Because most of the traders think that order block is SMC. They know boss and chalk and order block, which is enough for as a SMC trader. So I hope you understand that how we can identify SMT and how we can create a difference from the others. And this will definitely blow your mind. You can rewatch this video multiple times. And I will see you in the next chapter. Happy trading.